Hello and welcome back to season 1 episode 3 of the series of unfortunate events. This is the Reptile Room, of course, which is the second book of series of unfortunate events. And in the last one we saw the completion of the first book. Of course, if you want me to go back and look at the first part of episode 1, I still can do it. Just ask in the comments if you really want it. But yeah, I really like it so far. But I just think that the adaptation is really good because they're delving into more of like the parents. Or, you know, it's been a really long time since I've read the book, so maybe it's in the book as well, I'm not sure. Kobe Smulders is the mother and the inventor, and most probably the inspiration of where Violet gets her inventing as well, makes sense. But I don't think we'll see more of them because, you know, they're special guests, which means that they're not going to be here for a number of episodes. So anyway, let's dive right on in to the next episode. Single episode is nothing but dismay. Look away, look away. Okay, this is for the new episodes. Bo Welch. Barry Sonnenfeld. To Reptile Room, Part 1. Woe is me, broken-hearted crocodile. I hope this is more creepy because in the book it really read more as a horror kind of it read more of as a horror creeping kind of thing, so I really hope that plays into this. Anyway, I think that it should be more of the snakes playing in, you know, the reptiles. Well, it is called Lousy Lane. Well, that's probably why the apples are sour. Oh man, the sets are really beautiful, man. Well, it is in the will, so it makes sense. He's a cousin, uncle. What? It's like Mario Mario? It's this guy. Looks too poor and then looks back. That's a piano. Just snakes though. Like, what about turtles or... Gustav? That's not really safe at all, is it? He was in the movie we shall not speak of. That was supposed to represent the show called Avatar: The Last Airbender. You're supposed to be a very important character as well, but Mr. Shyamalan decided he didn't want exciting movie descriptions or storylines, but whatever. GG. The incredibly deadly viper. Alcohol. And woman. So you only found one woman that was like susceptible to snake venom? What about the other women? Yep. Dramatic irony, man. Yep. So, yeah. He's dead. They're in danger. Look. Don't answer it. Wait, what about the guy's research though? I think Count Olaf was part of their whole secret organization, and then he just got greedy, and then they kicked him out for too much greed. GG, con Olaf. So this Montgomery guy definitely knows. For now. Good. Oh shit. You disgust me. right. That's right. Well, you're saying that a movie can educate and make you love and delve you into something, whereas, you know, something the other side is that the movie does not entertain at all. That's true. Sing about this. Nickelodeon. I think if like adaptions take more effort to explain like how the love story as well, that'd be more interesting actually. Because all we know is that Count Olaf is actually just the bad man. Wow, rainbow. Nice. Finn. My tender and my delight. Run along. Really? Well said. Dillion. The moon seems very full and very fake. I'm sorry, I just know. That's not natural lighting, by the way. God, he's gonna die. Obviously. I've watched too many movies, man. She's applauding. That's good. That's a good sign. Yeah, you left the door open, man. Uncle Monty in the reptile room with the candlestick. Yep, that was it. Yeah, that was a good episode. Can't wait for the next one though, so yeah, not much to say, but see you in the next episode. See you guys.